गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द कॉन्ग्रुएंस, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉन्ग्रुएंस. देन वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एन आइसोसेलेस ट्रायंगल. देन वी हैव लर्नड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट थ्योरम्स ऑल्सो. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ माई एक्सरसाइज 7.1. So as you can see, what is given in the first question, exercise 7.1, in an quadrilateral ABCD, your AC side is equal to AD, okay? And AB side is bisecting angle A. So you have to show the congruency between triangle ABC and your triangle ABD. And what can you say about the BC and about BD? So now you have to find the similarity, okay? So as I can see here, what is given here, you can write down, in an equilateral, in an quadrilateral ABCD, your AC is already given equal to AD and your AB is bisecting angle A. So we have to prove that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. Okay, so if you see here, in triangle ABC as your above and ABD in your down, your AC is already given with AD. And AB is bisecting angle A. That means this line is dividing the whole angle A into two equal parts. That means we can say that angle CAB is equal to angle DAB. Okay. And you can see in both this triangle, your AB side is common. So here we can say that two sides and one angle. That's why we can say that it is following what congruency? SAS congruency, okay? And by CPCT, that is corresponding parts of corresponding triangle. That means if you see here, what are the remaining sides left to be proved? That is BC and BD side. Therefore, we can write that by CPCT, BC is equal to BD. Okay, students? Okay. So next, let us go for the question number 2. What is given here? ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD is equal to BC. So AD side is equal to your side BC, and it's a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means four sides, okay? And this angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. So we have to prove that triangle ABD and triangle BAC, we have to prove the congruency, and we have to see whether BD will be equal to AC from the logic of corresponding, that is CPCT. And third is, we have to prove that the angle ABD is also equal to angle BAC. So whenever you are given any questions of geometry, always you have to write the given things, what is given in the question and what you require to prove, and then you have to proceed for the answer. Okay. So see here what is given in triangle ABD and triangle BAC. Can you see all of you? So what is given here, that in triangle ABD and BAC, you can see AD is given equal to BC. Okay. Next, DAB is equal to angle CBA. And both the sides AB are equal. Therefore, it is following again SAS congruency. Okay. Next, by CPCT, we can conclude that BD is equal to AC. So, for the third proof, you see, already ABD angle is equal to angle BAC, it is given. And if you see both this triangle, what you see, AB is common. Okay. AB is equal to AB given. Then AD is equal to BC. And angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. And already from the second point, we have got that the side BD is also equal to the side AC. Therefore, by CPCT, what you have to see is, see in this two triangle, your side, two sides, okay? AB, then ADBC, then BD, AC, all these three sides are equal. Okay, then we can see that the remaining angle will be automatically equal. Therefore, by CPCT, it is concluding that angle ABD is equal to angle BAC. Okay. Okay. In question number 3, what is given? AD and BC are equal perpendiculars. Okay. To the line segment AB. So as you can see, angle A and angle B are 90 degree. So you have to show that CD is bisecting. So you have to show that CD is bisecting the side AB. Okay. So already again I told you, so you have to write what is given and what you need to prove. This is the proof part. So what is given? In the given figure, AB and BC are perpendicular to the line segment AB, and you have to prove that angle, you have to prove that CD is bisecting AB, isn't it? So from the triangle OBC and triangle OAD, your angle B and angle A are 90 degree. The side AD is equal to the side BC, and angle BOC is equal to angle AOD by vertically opposite angle. So by now, all of you have gone through the lines and angles chapter where you have understood what is vertically opposite angle. Okay. So if you see this three condition, two angles and one side, that's what it is following. What rule? That is by ASA rule, isn't it? Two angles and one side, that's why it is known as what? ASA rule. Okay, therefore by CPCT we can say that your side CD is bisecting the side AB. Okay, next question number 5. Line L is the bisector. Okay, you can see line L is bisecting the angle A. So I told you, whenever a line is bisecting any angle, it is always dividing that whole angle into two equal parts. Okay, and you can see here your angle Q and angle P both are 90 degree, isn't it? Now you have to show that, you have to show some connection between angle ABP and AQB. Okay, and one more, you have to show that the BP side is equal to BQ, or you can say that B is equidistant from the arms of angle A. Okay, so here what we can say, that from this figure we can say simply, very easy, that angle Q and angle P, both the angles are 90 degree. Your AB side is also common, and you can say that angle QAB is equal to angle BAP. These two angles are also equal. So in this two triangle, two angles and one sides are equal. Therefore, what rule it is following? That is ASA rule. And by CPCT, we can say that BP will be equal to the side PQ, isn't it? Okay. Next question number 4. I have proceeded to 5, so I want to go back to question number 4. L and M, you can see line L and L M are two parallel lines intersecting by another parallel line P and Q. You have to show that triangle ABC and triangle CDA are congruent. So I think you have got the logic from lines and angles, if I remember. That whenever two lines are cut by a transversal, there are some angles formed, alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles, corresponding angles. I think all of you understood this. So if you see triangle ABC and triangle AC, this triangle, you have to show the similarity, isn't it? So if you see, this angle will be equal to this angle by what property? Alternate angles, isn't it? Then this angle will be equal to this angle. Okay, and this side is common. So if you see here, in this two triangles, two angles, this one pair of angles equal, another pair of angles equal, and one pair and one side is common. So you can say this is following under what rule? That is ASA rule, isn't it? So in this way, you can easily conclude by looking at the diagram. If you are confirmed of how to do it, then you will get the answer to these questions. Okay, so in this way, today we have completed the 5 questions from the exercise 7.1. Thank you.